Achieving a connected Nigerian economy through ICT came to the fore at the July breakfast meeting of the Nigeria South Africa Chamber of Commerce. The General Manager, Enterprise Sales, MTN Nigeria, Mr. Dekunle Adebiyi, gave an overview of the Nigerian economy with the challenging indicators and the opportunities that abound.
It's not organ news. The Finance Minister, Mrs. Kemi Adeosu, also alluded to the fact that our economy is technically in recession. IMF has also projected that the economy will contract by 1.8% in 2016. This is the state of Nigeria. However, there are huge opportunities still in Nigeria that can be unlocked if we do the right things. Current challenges, foreign currency shortages due to lower oil revenues. One of the challenges also is very low power generation. There's weak investor confidence. Inflation are now in double digits. There's high rate of unemployment. And of course, outputs are quite low across all sectors. We are all aware as well that the value of the naira has been on the downward trend. I think it's about 350, 375, 325. How much is it now? 378. So it's not been it's not been standing on very strong legs in recent times. So that means that people will pay more for products and services, as it were, because the higher the inflation, the more difficult it is. This is not showing completely, but the figure there, inflation figure, as at June 2016, is said to be at 16.5%. Now, having looked at the state of the nation, let's quickly look at productivity as well. Quite a number of very good discussions around what productivity is assumed to be. But possible as it might sound, there is a fundamental error in thinking that government exists to run the economy. The economy runs through the efforts of people and what they actually do. It is the extent to which you and I are productive that builds up the economy. Then government can come in addition to other organizations, to bring people together into meaningful units of production to ensure that the productivity in each unit of effort is harnessed into a collaborative and effective trust to build up the economy. For us to achieve the economic growth and development that we so desire in Nigeria, at the base of it, the very foundation of it, is that we need to increase production. We cannot just be consuming. We need to increase production. If we increase production, there will be increase in flow of goods and services. Of course, that will also impact the size of the market because the markets will get bigger. There will be bigger incentives to invest. A lot more jobs will be created. And of course, we will see growth and productivity.
He shared the role of the ICT sector in driving productivity and growth for Nigeria, as well as identified five key pillars to be considered.
How do we now link ICT to this productivity? Increasing productivity is central to boosting per capita income, that's obvious. And ICT has been identified as an effective tool for boosting productivity because of its huge potential to impact positively on every sector of the economy, and of course, help us to drive up globalization. So it does have a multiplier effect. This potential of ICT leads to significant results when all stakeholders, mark the word, all stakeholders work with ICT players to enhance services, applications, and content that will create new markets, that will stimulate economic activity, that has capacity to reduce costs, and of course, productivity will increase. So it's either you're making more money or you're reducing your costs, and you find that your profitability will also go up, and you have incentive to do more. And we've seen quite a huge growth. According to eMarketer, in 2014, it was projected that Nigeria will, by the year 2016, which we are now, we'll be having about 69.1 million internet users. But according to the NCC, we already have 92 million. So we actually have even surpassed the projections. So you see, you'll agree with me that there is been a lot of growth around the use of basic ICT. Now, we identified 5 pillars in MTN where we believe that if we get right, there will be the kind of explosion that we actually are expecting around ICT. Infrastructure investment is key. Markets and competition is also very important. We need to increase the size of the market. We need to encourage competition that will bring down prices and increase quality, more importantly. We need to look at the areas of applications and content. And of course, skills and education for IT is key. And policies and regulations need to also support further expansion of these key strategic areas are highlighted here. And starting from number 5, policy and regulation. Is essential areas to be covered by such policies include protection of critical infrastructure, security, privacy, and quality of service. Markets and competition. Regulation and policies must encourage multiple players, must promote diversity in platform technologies and services that promote widespread usage. And of course, we mentioned infrastructure investment. A lot of investment is still required around infrastructure in ICT.
Nigeria's opportunity for economic diversification lies in sectors like the ICT. This will be achieved through a spirited public-private sector partnership.